Hey there, it's Arian and welcome to the Game Dev Box. In today's video, we'll be exploring how to create a singleton pattern for your game. We'll be taking a look at how to build one and why it can be useful. Basically, a singleton pattern is a design pattern that restricts us to having just one instance of an object. The cool thing is that any script can access the singleton, allowing you to easily connect objects to important parts of the game like the player or other game systems. This is really useful when it comes to connecting unrelated objects and scripts to global systems like an audio manager. You've probably noticed this in Unity when calling code like camera.main or eventsystem.current. So we can use singletons to access them and their properties. So, let's take a look at how this all works. I've got a scene here with a sphere and a cube, or button, or something like that. My goal is to create another object whenever the sphere lands on the cube. So, I already have a player script attached to the sphere which controls its movement, and I've added an onCollisionEnter method to check if the sphere collides with something that has a switch tag. Before writing any code, let's create another class called SwitchController. To create an instance of the cube, I've added a switch prefab property. In the start method, I'll instantiate this object in a random position with the default rotation. I have a method called switchInstantiate which it has exactly the same code in the start function. To ensure that the object is destroyed when it's no longer needed, I've also created a destroySwitch method. Now, to access the properties of the SwitchController class, I need to create an instance of it in the PlayerController script. Once I've done that, I can access the switchInstantiate and destroySwitch methods. However, since I only need one instance of the SwitchController class, I'll use the singleton pattern. To do this, I'll add a public, static, and then the name of the current class, which is SwitchController, and a name. With the public get and private set, we are going to limit the instance to set only in this script. In the awake function, which runs before start, I'll check if an instance of this class already exists, and if it's not this class, I'll destroy it. Otherwise, we'll just set the instance to this class. That's all we need to do for creating singleton patterns. Now that I've implemented the singleton pattern, I can remove the line of code in the player controller script that creates an instance of the SwitchController class. Instead, I'll call the SwitchController class and use the instance to access its public methods. As you can see, we managed to implement the singleton pattern very easily. Singletons can be very convenient because they allow you to connect different parts of your game more easily. For example, you could use a singleton to make the player's position publicly accessible to enemies or use one to expose the player's health to the UI. Also, you could call a sound effect function on a singleton from any script in the game. So long as the variable or function exists on the singleton and it's publicly accessible, other scripts will be able to use it without you needing to set up a reference to it first. Lastly, to avoid errors and make our code more stable, I'll add an onDestroy function to the SwitchController class that sets the instance to null whenever the object is destroyed. In the PlayerController script, I'll add an if statement to check if the instance of the SwitchController class exists before running any code. And that's it. We've successfully implemented the singleton pattern. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, be sure to hit the like button and let me know what you think in the comments. Of course, if you are interested in more game tips and tutorials, be sure to subscribe. I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.